I want to start off with a question. So by a show of hands, who of you prefers coffee over tea? Now, imagine I only bring out tea, and even though many of you would prefer coffee, you now have to drink the tea. It's not the end of the world, but it's not coffee. Now, I believe in technology. And the question I just asked you is what happens in classrooms today. We have 45 learners, each with different personalities, abilities, and learning styles. But yet, we teach everyone the same as if one size fits all. But what if instead we brew the perfect cup for each learner, making their learning personal? The first line in one of my favorite quotes from the iconic Miss Houston Reed: "I believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way." These words remind us that the future lies in the hands of our learners. And to guide them well, we need to recognize their individuality, their unique strength, their interests, and their learning styles, making their learning more personal. But in order to make something personal, we need to know something about that person. And as teachers, it starts with a simple question: who are the learners in my classroom? You see, life gave us different generations. It gave us generation baby boomers, and they are productive, hardworking team players, the mentors of society today. Then it gave us Generation X, known for being self-reliant, resourceful, and independent. Then I came, millennial, that grew up with the internet and are very comfortable using digital technology. And then Gen Z, the first generation to grow up with the smartphones and social media from a young age. And now we have Gen Alpha, a generation growing up with AI, smart devices, and voice assistants as part of their daily lives. Now, why am I telling you this? This is a reminder that life has changed, time has changed, and our learners have changed. I remember when I started my teaching journey, I saw myself as the authority in the class. I decided what would be learned, how it would be taught, and how my students would receive the information. It was a classic teacher said, learner do relationship, and if they don't, there were repercussions. Now, something was missing. As someone that always strived for excellence, I wasn't achieving this with my class. I was pouring knowledge into them, but it wasn't sticking. So I started to self-reflect. And I transformed my thinking. So I opened my classrooms for discussions. I allowed the learners to make decisions. I allowed them to give suggestions. And as I mentioned, I allowed them to lead the way. And once I let my students lead the way, they didn't just lead me to technology. They showed me that technology was a bridge. They showed me that they were technology natives, and withholding that from them is withholding their strength, because I was teaching in a way that worked for me, but not necessarily for them. I want to take you into my class for a minute, and I want you to look at this video. And it's a simple question I asked my learners, just like I did to you with the coffee and the tea. And the question was, would you rather work in your workbooks, as you can see, no ends, or would you rather work on your tablets? And as you can see, a unanimous win for the tablets. Now, some of you might say that this might be a staged video, but I can guarantee you, you can go to any classroom in the country and the results would be the same, because this generation is digital natives. When I allowed my learners to lead the way, everything changed. The class became fun. It became loud. It became interactive. It turned a grumpy, dictated teacher like myself into a loving, inspiring teacher I am today. I want to show you another video, and this is more reaction-based. I want you to listen to the excitement in their voices. I want you to see the excitement on their faces. I want you to see the happiness on their faces. Now, this was reactions based on marks they received that they did on the tablets. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I don't know about you, but I wasn't this happy when I received my marks back in school. But this is just a reminder to me to never stop listening to our learners. A few of my learners wanted extra classes, and thanks to quizzes, an online quizzing platform, now they have it. Instead of me leading the lesson, they now taking the charge by creating their own quizzes and challenge each other on these quizzes. This happens before school, it happens in class, and it happens at home. And what's nice about this and great about this is the instant feedback they receive. They can see where they made mistakes, learn from the correct answers, and redo the quizzes until they master the material. This approach not only fosters independence, but it allows learners to take personal guidance, give them personal guidance on their work and taking responsibility of their own work. They can make the quizzes easy. They can make it difficult. They can tailor it as their knowledge progresses, taking control of how and what they learn. Now, as we know and as we see, AI, it's a huge topic at the moment, especially in education. But we are scared to use it, and we are scared to talk about it to our learners. In my class, however, I have embraced AI, and I have introduced my learners to the likes of ChatGPT, Gemini, Bing Image Creator, just to mention a few. And teaching them how to use these tools effectively and responsibly have opened up new learning possibilities. With AI, they can now explore concepts beyond the textbook, ask questions whenever curiosity strikes, and receive personal guidance on their schoolwork. I want to show you another video. And I've mentioned that AI has opened up new learning possibilities. Learners can now ask questions if they don't understand something and use prompts like the one you see on the screen. Use the following summary to create a 10-mark quiz. And just like that, they will have access to questions and answers just by copying and pasting information. They can go a little bit further and challenge themselves by asking, make the quiz a little bit difficult, challenging their knowledge and making the quiz difficult. This is new possibilities that learners have. What about taking a picture of something they don't understand? They can now take pictures, uploading it, and ask questions when the teacher are not around. Questions like, explain question 1 and 2 so that it makes sense. And what's important, explain it as if I'm a fifth grader, dumbing down complex situations. Now, this is an example, ladies and gentlemen, of a personalized tutor at home for free whenever the learner needs that guidance. But everything is not smooth sailing. And as educators, we know that teaching isn't a solo effort. It's a triangle that involves the teacher, the learners, and the parents. And we know that different schools have different challenges. So what happens when learners don't have access to devices such as desktops and laptops at home? At my school, this is a reality. However, most parents do have access to cell phones. And this is where I found a way to keep this triangle intact. I've started to send homework in the forms of links directly to the parents' cell phones. In this way, this simple act turns parents into active participants into the child's learning journey, because they now have to make sure that learners complete the quizzes, read the documents, and view the videos. They also have to complete forms themselves to make sure that they are up to date with the learner's learning journey. This way, they are not only overseeing the learning journey, they are experiencing it and understanding the challenges of the child firsthand. Now, this is what happens when we use technology inside of the classroom. But the possibilities of what our learners can create becomes endless if we allow them to explore and discover. I want you to meet Bradley, a grade 7 learner that's already a content creator, crafting educational videos that inspire and teaches his peers. Then there's Lauren, who launched a podcast interviewing fellow students and teachers about their successes, creating a platform to share stories about growth and achievement. Then there's Damien, a grade 5 learner, who wrote a rap song about anti-bullying and made a music video at school, using his voice to spread awareness and to make a difference. You know, as teachers, we often say, we hold the future in our hands, but yet we teach as if we are stuck in the past. Our learners are not the learners of yesterday. They are the leaders of tomorrow. They will be content creators, so let's empower them to create. They will be software developers, so let's give them the code. They will use AI to solve problems that we can't even imagine right now. So let's guide them at mastering it today. They will shape the future. So let's start teaching them the future today. Thank you.